Hello, hello, welcome to WebSense Pro, welcome to another video, and this is an updated video of previously created video. So we previously created a tutorial which helped you guys to add password protection to your collection page. Currently there is no free solution available for that, but the previous solution which we created was not working perfectly due to some issues that when someone was searching on your store, the product was still available and it was showing up on all product as well. So in this video, we'll create a private collection which will be password protected, and all of the products within that collection will not be visible anywhere else in the store. So if you search that, those products will not be visible, and if you visit any other collection, those products will not be visible. So that's the solution which we'll be implementing. I have my development store up and running, and in this I'll create a new collection and then add the password protection, and we'll show you guys step by step on how you can do that. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, comment on the video below, which will help me motivate, create more solutions for you guys, and let's get into it. So first let's go to the back end and create a new collection. Okay, here's the dashboard of the Shopify store. I'm going to click on products and then click on collections. And here I'll create a new collection by clicking on this create collection button, and I'm going to name my collection private collection and then click on save. Perfect. Now I'll click on online store, and here I have the latest version of Dawn 12.0.0 activated. I'm going to click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme. Make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. In case you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. Okay, now click on edit code. And here we will create a new template. So click on add a new template button. And then from this drop down, select collection. And then click on liquid. And then name it private. You can name it whatever you want, but I'm just naming it private because the code which I have for this template is also related to private. So you can name it whatever you want. Okay, click on done. Okay, and here is the code instruction. Here is the step-by-step instructions which you will find in this YouTube video description. I'll paste the link. And in the newly created collection, we will copy this code. So click on copy code and paste the code here. And then click on save. Perfect. Now the template which we created, we will assign this template to the collection, the private collection. And for that, let's go back to the backend. I'm going to open that on a new tab. And again, click on products and then click on collections. And from here, select this private collection which you created, and then select the template. So the template code which we created, we will need to select this here and then click on save. And now we will manually add one of the product. So just select the drop down, click on manually. You can add multiple products on this collection page. I'm going to add one product for now to show you guys how it's gonna work. Okay, let's click on browse and search for the product. I'm going to make this product, select it, click on blue t-shirt, and then click on add. Again, I have just added one product for now. You can add multiple products if you want to. Okay, that's it. Now we will move on to the next steps which we have. Now we will need to add private tag to our customer and to the product which we want to display as a password protected. And how we can do that? So first click on customers, and I have only one customer, so you can give permission to multiple customers if you want to. All you have to do is just add tag to that customer as private, and I'm going to tag this customer as private. So here's the tags, just add in private and then click on save. Now I'm going to add the same tag to my product as well, which I want to hide. And now click on products and then search for that product. So I have that on top. I'm going to select that. And then I'm going to add a tag called private. Perfect. I have added this private tag, and after adding this tag, click on save. And now let's add this collection to the menu. Click on online store, click on navigation, and to our main menu, let's add in the collection. So I'm going to name it private collection. You can name it whatever you want, collections, and then search for the collection which we created. Here's the collection which we created called private collection. And then click on add button here, and then click save. Okay, now when I go to my store and hit refresh, I have this private collection showing up. And when I click on that, it shows me the login option that to view the products in this collection, you will have to log in, right? But when I go to home page and select the view all and go to all product page, that product is still available. So the further steps which we are going to implement will hide this product on all of the other collection, on the search page, on the all product page, etc., etc. Okay, now let's proceed with that. How we can do that? Now we will go to our instruction tutorial, and in here we have step 2, where we will update main-collection-product-grid.liquid file. And let's search for it. So here's the file, click on that. And in this file, you will need to find this code. So that's the code which we will replace with the following code. Okay, now let's search for this li. I'm going to search for card-product within main-collection-product-grid.liquid file. Press Ctrl F if you are on Windows and Command F if you are on Mac. Hit next, and here's the li, here's the code which we need to replace with the following code, right? So I'm going to copy the code and paste it here. Perfect, and then hit save. And now when I go to my all product collection page and hit refresh, you can see that the blue t-shirt product is no longer visible on my products. But if I go to my home page and check out the featured collection widget, you can see that this product is still visible. So the next step which we will be doing will remove this from the featured collection, and it will not be visible unless the customer is tagged as private. Okay, now let's move on to the next step, which is update the feature collection. Now we will navigate to feature-collection.liquid file and replace the following code with this code. Okay, let's navigate to our feature-collection.liquid file on our code editor. So here's the file, and in here we will search for this code. So again, let's search for card-product and replace this li, which is here, with the below code. Okay, so here's the li which we will be replacing with the code. Okay, so I'm just going to click on copy code and then paste it here and then hit save. Now after saving the file, wait for 30 seconds to 1 minute to make sure it is completely propagated, and then go back to your home page and then hit refresh to see if that product is still visible or not. So hit refresh, and now you can see my privately product, which is tagged as private, not visible on featured products, but it's still available when I search it, and it's still available on the search page, right? Now the next step which we will be doing will remove it from the search page as well. Okay, let's move on to that. Now that's our fourth step where we will be updating main-search.liquid file. And in here, we will search for this code and replace it with the below code here. And now I'm going to again search this li. Let's copy this code here and search our file. Okay, so here's the li which we will be replacing completely. So here's the li which is ending on line number 319. I'm going to check that again if it's the correct one. Yep, that's the correct one. So going to replace this whole code with the code provided below. So click on copy code button and paste it here. And then hit save. And again, wait for 30 seconds to 1 minute to make sure the code is completely propagated, and then go to your search page and hit refresh. And here you go. Now your product is no longer visible on the search page as well. Cool, right? Now the private collection which we created will have this product showing up. So click on private collection. And now it's asking you to log in. So I've already created a customer which I showed you guys on the back end. Now I'm going to log in from that customer using username and password. So that's my username, and I have just created a test user in order to show you guys, and I'm going to sign in from that user. And now let's go to our private collection page. And here we go. Our password protected collection is completely ready to go, where we have currently one product, and this specific product is no longer visible on any other collection page on any home page as well. And we can test it out by adding tag to some more products. So let's go to products and then add the second product tagged as well. So open that product, scroll down and add private as your tag. Here's our tag, and then click on save. After adding the private tag, I'll add this product to my private collection. So I'm going to open the collections on a new tab, select on private collection, and then search for this product here where we added the private tag. So that's the product. Click on done, and then hit save. Okay, it's automatically saved. Cool. Now, when we go to our private collection and hit refresh, you can see that we have these two products showing up on our private collection page. And now when we log out from this user account, these two products will no longer be visible on any other collection. Now let's log out from our current user, because this is a customer where we have added the tag as private. So these products are visible to this customer. Now I'm going to log out from this customer account. It's automatically redirected to home page. And now when I search for these two products, you can see that these two products are no longer available. So it's not on my all product page. It's only showing up on private collection page, which is password protected. Now let's log in again and go to private collection. And here we have these two products showing up, which we marked as private. Cool, right? So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys like it. If you do, let me know in the comment below. If you are unable to implement that, let me know in the comment below. I'll try my best to help you as soon as possible. I've been getting a lot of comments. It's hard to catch up to reply all of those comments, but I will try my best to reply them as soon as possible. Also, we have created a lot of tutorials recently, swatches on product page, swatches on collection page. We have created a before after slider. All of these videos links will be in this video description. So until next video, have a great day.